life of the King. Come learn and see lessons for you.
The Kingdom Connection, you leave the modern world behind and enter into the ancient civilization of kings who lived over 2,000 years ago. We will be able to peek in on some defining moments in Bible history. Throughout the experience, you will have the opportunity to guess what you think happened next. Welcome to your interactive Bible adventure tour, The Kingdom Connection. Let me tell you how it works. The kings will start off frozen in statue poses as the narrator tells their stories. The actors playing these kings will remain in character, which means if you ask them a question, they will answer you as if they are really the kings of old.
I am so ready for this. Ancient stories are my jam. Hashtag Bible nerd.
She's not joking. In second grade, she made a full-scale model of the Tower of Babel, complete with sound effects. Freaked everyone out.
Impressive and oddly ambitious.
I heard there was a challenge at the end, right? That's why I'm here.
Correct. A quiz at the end.
Ooh, I've been waiting for the kingdom quiz. Ask me anything. Anything at all. Who's the youngest king in Israel's history? King Josiah. He was crowned at age 8. Hey, can you believe it?
Well, my name's Josiah, so that puts me up ahead already. Up top.
I see this is going to be competitive. I better take notes.
I think we are ready to begin. Our tour begins with the story of our first king, King Saul.
Before Saul, Israel had never had a king, but instead he had followed the people God had chosen to lead them, like Moses, Joshua, and Samuel. But when Samuel grew old, the elders of Israel gathered together and said,
"You are old. Give us a king like all the other nations."
"But the Lord, he is your king."
"We want to be like everyone else. We want a king we can see to lead us and fight our battles."
We'll be right back. but they have rejected me. I will choose their king. God gave the Israelites a king named Saul. Now Saul was very, very handsome. In fact, there was not a more handsome man than he among the sons of Israel.
There was not a more handsome man than me among the sons of Israel.
Then Samuel took a crown and placed it on Saul's head.
The Spirit of the Lord will come powerfully upon you. Once these signs are fulfilled, do whatever your hands find to do, for God is with you.
And God changed Saul's heart, and the Spirit of God came mightily upon him.
Once Samuel assembled all the tribes of Israel to announce Saul as king, what do you think Saul did?
Ooh, I know. He gave a big speech to the people.
Let's watch and see.
And I present to you the one who the Lord has chosen.
Saul? Where did he go?
Saul was hiding behind the trees.
Saul, get out here. This is who the Lord has chosen. Long live the king.
Long live the king.
Long live me.
Does anyone have any questions for King Saul?
I do. Why'd you hide behind the trees? Were you scared?
Pass.
Pass? You can't pass.
I was just resting. I was not afraid of being king. That's it. Next question.
How long were you king?
42 years. It would have been longer, but someone stole my throne.
What? That's messed up. I would have pounded him.
I tried, believe me, I tried, but he kept escaping.
Tough break, man.
It really was.
Excuse me, Saul didn't obey all the rules that God gave him. Here, in 1 Samuel 15, verses 10 to 11, it says, Then the word of the Lord came to Samuel, saying, I regret that I have made Saul king, for he has turned back from following me and has not carried out my commands. So God replaced Saul with a man who would listen to God, and that man was David.
Like I said, someone stole my throne.
You brought your own Bible?
You didn't.
God told Samuel to anoint young David, and the Spirit of the Lord came mightily upon David from that day forward.
Boring. Are we getting to the old David and Goliath story yet?
Indeed we are. The Philistines had a champion fighter named Goliath.
Grr!
Isn't that the same person who played Samuel?
Rosie actually plays a number of supporting roles. Now she's Goliath.
Cool!
Goliath was huge and had advanced armor and weapons. Every day he stood and shouted,
"Who's a man and have him come down to me? If he is able to fight and kill me, we will become your subjects. If I overcome him, you will become our subjects and serve us."
Saul and all the Israelites were terrified. But what do you think David did?
Ooh, I know. He fought Goliath and stuff.
Let's watch and see.
You come to me with sword and spear, but I come to you with sword. Let all your things serve God in this world. The balance of sword and spear will give you in the darkness.
Now I know who made the starry sky, and I know who taught the birds to fly. Who made the sun to rise and fall? Who taught the earth to spin? There's no need to fear. I know my God is here. It's not my battle. It's not my fight. My God is on it. He'll do what's right. It's not my battle. I will proclaim.
He'll do what's right.
It's not my battle. I will proclaim that all the glory is to his name. That all the glory is to his name.
And David defeated the Philistine with a sling and a stone.
Yay!
So David was just crazy strong? I guess that makes sense.
No, that's not it. God used David because he had a heart that was surrendered to him, not because he was strong.
You're feeling great.
Don't be silly.
Come on now, let's continue with our
lunch break.
Finally,
great.
I need to use the little king's room.
I'm sorry, it's a union thing. You really don't want hungry kings. It's not pretty.
These people are serious about their food.
I'll see you back in an hour. Welcome back. Let's journey a bit into our next kingdom.
Ooh, the next king. Is it Ahab, Omri, Jehoshaphat?
God bless you.
Jehoshaphat.
God bless you again.
Never mind.
David was prospering in all of his ways, for the Lord was with him.
The Lord is my rock, my fortress, and my deliverer. He rescued me from my foes, who were too strong for me. The Lord lives. Praise be to my rock. I will praise the Lord among the nations. I will sing the praises of your name.
David wrote psalms of worship to God when he was happy, when he was sad, and when he was afraid.
I need two volunteers to help read some of the psalms David wrote. How about you two?
Awesome. Psalm 34, verse 17 through 19. The righteous cry out, and the Lord hears them. The Lord is close to the brokenhearted and saves those who are crushed in spirit.
How did he feel when he wrote that?
He sounds pretty sad.
Yes.
Psalm 32, 7. You are my hiding place. You protect me from trouble and surround me with songs of deliverance. Maybe he wrote this when he was scared.
Psalm 28, 7.
The Lord is my strength.
The Lord is my strength and my shield. My heart trusts in him and I am helped. My heart leaps for joy and I'll give thanks to him in song.
What do you think about that one?
He was thankful.
Yes, but the most important thing about David is that he had a humble heart. He loved God and trusted him. David loved to sing to God with all of his heart.
Lord, I want to be wise and I want to be strong, but still I'm going to praise you. And sometimes I fail and sometimes I doubt, but still I'm going to praise you. Why am I discouraged? Help me trust you, overcome, and today we'll remember.
Kings in the Bible were seeking to please God.
Tell me about it. There's Nadab, Tibni, Joash, Ahab.
Blah, blah, blah. Stop being a know-it-all. There's other people here.
Oh, sorry. When I get excited about something, it all just spills out.
It's all right. Let's journey a bit into our next kingdom.
I am the greatest king in all of the land, King Herod.
King Audrey, where's our regular King Herod?
Sometimes in the course of kingdom events, certain kings get sick and understudies get a big break performing in their place. Herod has a fever, I'm Herod's understudy. And I am the greatest king this land has ever seen!
Was King Herod British?
Sometimes understudies only know one accent.
Oh.
King Herod was happily reigning over the land when he heard a commotion about a baby king being born during his reign.
What? Another ruler has been born here? There can't be another king. Go and make a careful search for the child. As soon as you find him, report him to me so I may go and...
Psst, worship him.
What?
Worship him. Herod was pretending he wanted to worship the baby Jesus, although we all know he really wanted to kill him.
No one can prove that.
No offense, I don't think that's a secret.
As soon as you find the baby, report him to me so I may go and worship him. Let me know. I can throw him a big party or something. My event planning resources are limitless here at college. He's fixing to steal my throne. And how's the little baby gonna rule this land alone? I promise I won't hurt him. I just really want to say, welcome to the neighborhood and brighten up his day.
Does anyone have any questions for King Herod?
I do, but may I ask Herod in private?
Well, normally our questions are...
I'd be happy to answer this fine fellow's question privately. Wait, you're not a king, are you?
No.
All right, whatever King Herod says. That's what's so great about our interactive adventure tour. Every tour is different.
I'm looking for something.
Just what might you be seeking, young man? Surely not a babe king. So I haven't had much luck in that area.
No, the answer to the final question at the end of the quiz. I need a boost to ace it.
Oh! A little help to claim your rightful place as ruler of all the land? Listen, all you have to do is study the stars. My advisors always use the stars to help solve their difficult problems. Run along now. I have kingly matters to attend to.
The stars. I mean, like, do you have a cheat sheet or something? The stars. Well, I guess the answer to the final question is the stars. Thanks, Herod.
You know I'm just an actor, right? Not a real bad guy. I was just staying in character.
And we move on from King Herod to someone who had a very important role in the Bible. He was very wise. Does anyone know who he was?
Was it Solomon?
Right you are. Let's drop in on his kingdom and take a look.
The Lord appeared to Solomon in a dream. And God said, ask for whatever you want me to give you. Solomon answered,
you have shown great kindness to my father David because he was faithful to you. Your chosen people are very great, but I do not know how to lead them. please give me wisdom to know right from wrong.
The Lord was pleased that Solomon had asked for this. So he said, since you have asked for this, and not long life or wealth, I will do what you have asked. I will give you a wise and discerning heart.
The Bible says that God gave Solomon great wisdom, insight, and understanding as measureless as the sand on the seashore. Men of all nations came to listen to Solomon's wisdom.
Discerning heart to govern your people and distinguish between right and wrong.
Ready now to participate in the Kingdom Quiz? Actors, take your places. Players, step forward and bring. Players, step forward and bring your whiteboards. Write your answers down. After each character asks the question, after all characters have spoken, you may reveal your answers.
Question number one. What did I tell the wise men I wanted to do with the baby king? A. Dance with him. That's what it says. B, crown him the new king, or C, worship him.
Question number two. When did I raise songs of worship and praise to God? A, when I was sad. B, when I was thankful. C, when I was scared. D, all of the above.
Question three. Why did God choose another king to replace me? A, because he was better looking, doubtful. B, because I disobeyed God's rules. Or sea because I couldn't handle the pressure.
This is open note, right?
Yes, if you took notes, you may use them.
Perfect.
Question number 4. What did I ask God for? A, long life, B, wisdom, or C, wealth?
And the kingdom quiz, final question.
How can we have a heart that seeks God rather than a heart that seeks its own gain?
Please write your answers down. You have 15 seconds.
I have no idea what this answer is. Thanks for the help, Herod.
Young man, I think you just possibly misunderstood what I was saying earlier.
Pens down. Now reveal your answers. The answers are...
C, worship him.
D, all the above.
B, because it disobeys God's rules.
And B, wisdom.
And the answer to the final question is...
The stars! The answer is the stars!
I'm sorry, but the answer to how can we have a heart that seeks God rather than a heart that seeks its own gain is...
God's Spirit living in you!
This was a dumb activity anyway.
Oh. Young man, I think you possibly misunderstood. You see, I was in character pretending to be King Herod. I would never cheat and give away the final answers!
This was a dumb activity anyway.
It's okay, Josiah. You did great. We're all learning.
But you did good on your own without cheating like I did.
But Josiah, we aren't living on our own. Ever since we are baptized, Jesus lives inside us.
Lots of kings thought they could do it all on their own, and they ended up failing. God says the only way we can have strength and to live a life that pleases him is through his power of his Spirit living within us.
Well, if impossible with men, it's possible with God.
Jesus conquered the powers of darkness, defeating death on the cross, and now we can live with the Spirit in us every day.
Can he breathe in to the dust? Can he make suns out of us? Life is in his mind.
He can do it. Yes, he can.
now that I don't know much about the Bible.
I'd love to talk with you more about it, and I can show you some of my cardboard models of Solomon's temple.
Start slowly, Lord. That's not scary.
It's okay.
But first you need to know Jesus. He is our connection to God's kingdom. Because of his sacrifice,